Tired of being told to just Google it, even though you have and you still can't find what you're looking for? Then this video is for you because I'm covering 10 Google search tips to find exactly what you want when you want it. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a metric ton of Google content. And today is no different because I'm sharing the best Google search tips to help you quickly find what you're looking for. So let's go. So as we get started, we're not gonna focus too much on the tabs in Google search, you know, like news and images and video and books tabs and so on, because I feel like you are already pretty familiar with that whole realm. Instead, most of our focus will be on Google search tips, utilizing the Google search bar. Plus, I'm leaving one of my favorite Google search tips to the end, so be sure to watch all the way through. The first thing to review that's kind of like an added bonus for you is I want to make sure you're using those advanced search options when necessary. So here's what that looks like. Once you've made a Google search, head on over to your settings and select advanced search. Here, you'll be able to hone in on exactly what it is that you're searching for by setting up more search parameters. And quick tip, I always use advanced search if I'm filtering a search by usage rights. So this is really handy if you're working on a presentation or something public facing and you want to ensure that you can use the results like any images, for example, with no copyright issues. But the advanced search is just a little extra nugget to wet your beaks. But let's actually get down to business and dive into Google search tip number one. Search directly within a website itself. Yes, you can do that right from Google. I officially just ended your endless searching on a site to find that article you know they posted, but you just can't seem to find it. So just type in your search term, then space, and then type in the keyword site, followed by a colon, and then just the website you'd like to search. And make sure there's no spaces here. So here's my example here. Carey Price, space, site, colon, NHL.com. And now let's hit enter, and boom. Only search results for Carey Price from NHL.com are given in my search results. Google search tip number two, use quotation marks. This is really handy if you're searching for something specific or a specific string of words or phrase. So what you're doing by adding a quotation mark followed by your search query and then ending with another quotation mark is that you want Google to search for that specific phrase in that exact order. So as my example here, there's a difference in searching queer eye fashion in quotes as opposed to just queer eye fashion, which would pull up search results containing those three words, but in any order. So let's hit enter and look. The first search result is literally the phrase as I typed it in quotation marks. Google search tip number three, include or exclude keywords, and all it takes is a little plus or minus symbol to completely change the way you search. So all you have to do is put a plus symbol directly in front of words you want Google to include in the search results, and then adversely, insert a minus symbol directly in front of any words you want to exclude. Google search tip number four, use the asterisk symbol to fill in the blank. Yes, really. And heads up, because this is actually one of the coolest Google search hacks for when you can't remember those song lyrics. Using an asterisk in Google search will signal Google to leave that as a placeholder that you need the search engine to fill. So, using song lyrics as an example, I'll use my quotation tricks here too. And what's that Taylor Swift song? Okay, quote, take me to the, I'm gonna put an asterisk, where, and then I'll just end quote because I don't remember the lyrics. So now I'll just hit enter, and would you look at that top search result, lyrics for Taylor Swift's The Lakes. And before we jump into Google search tip number 5, if you're liking this video, please consider, I don't know, giving it a like, or maybe you want to go one step further and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. I'd be ever so grateful. And now back to our regularly scheduled programming. Coming in at number 5 is to search similar sites. Ah, a great Google search tip indeed. So, a perfect example of how this would come in handy is, let's say you have a website that you love and you go on it all the time, but you want similar content because maybe you're a little bored of this just one site. In the Google search bar, simply type in the word related with a colon, and then the site name you want similar results to. So we can type in Amazon or something like that. And notice here, there are no spaces, and just hit enter. Boom, and here we go. We've got Walmart and Overstock and Macy's and Rakuten. Oh man, I can't stand those Rakuten commercials. You know the ones. But I digress. Coming in at number 6 on my list for the best Google search tips is to search for multiple words or phrases. Yes, all at once. So this is really simple. All you have to do is use those trusty quotation marks around a phrase you want to search. And we'll use a quote and then type in or in caps and then add in your other phrase in quotes once again. And there we go. So we've got results for how to train a dog or dog training tips. So you can do this exact same search with just words as well. You just wouldn't use the quotation marks. So here's an example. We could do chocolate cake or vanilla cake. And now we'll get search results that have either both or both chocolate or vanilla. Oh, and ooh, would you look at these top results? Choconilla cake, wowza. And what do you think I prefer, by the way? Chocolate or vanilla? Leave a comment below and don't let me down. All right, Google search tip number 7. Search for your weather via your zip code. I know, you can search for weather and then your city, but this is way cooler and can be more precise. So all you have to do is type in weather and then space and then add in your zip code and blammo, weather results tailored directly to your zip code. And no, that's not my zip code, but nice try. Okay, number 8 on the list, search for and find specific files. Yes, you can really search for files on Google too. What can't you do with Google? So this works by accessing any publicly available files that are floating around the interwebs. Just type in the name or title or keywords from a report that you need. Then we'll hit space and then type in file type colon, all one word. And then if you put in PDF, still with no space, hit enter, you'll get PDF search results with that specific keyword you entered as part of that title. So look, all our results here are for NHL PDFs. Now, the same can be done for other file extensions too. Like, I don't know, maybe you want an Excel spreadsheet. So let's just change the file type to XLSX and hit enter. Google search tip number 9, search Google with a picture. Yes, I've mentioned this one before. Ooh, but she's so good, she's back again. So if you've ever found yourself admiring artwork or a piece of tech gear or a bag that somebody has that you want, but you don't know what it is, you can either snap a photo of it or you can take that URL and paste it into Google to help you find the item. So here's how to search Google with a picture. From Google, click on the Images tab, and now from here, click on the camera icon in the search bar and upload a photo or paste the URL. So I'm gonna upload because I've already snapped a picture of a jacket I like. And now Google will automatically fill in some of the description for you. How crazy is that? Wowza. Or if this doesn't really fit this keyword description up here, you could also describe it as best as you can if you don't think that Google did a good job for you automatically. So now, as you can see, Google will pull up either the exact image or something closely matching that image. How neat is that? All right, we are nearing the end now, and as promised is one of my all-time favorite Google search tips. Coming in at number 10 is to set a custom date range. That's right, you can now weed out all those old, irrelevant, outdated articles. Here's how. So, after you've entered in a search, hit the tools option underneath the search bar, and now click on anytime. And in this dropdown, you can filter results by the past hour or week, month, year, or make a custom range. I just love this so much. So maybe I don't want anything older than, you know, like 2015, for example. How great is this? Do I keep saying how every Google search tip is so great? Well, that's because they are. And remember, if you want even more Google search tips, check out the links in the description below. So those are my 10 Google search tips to find exactly what you're looking for. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite Google search tips and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for even more Google content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Ta-da! That's it, that's it, that's a wrap. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-da.